my mom, she was like, Emmy, do you want some ice cream? And I couldn't hear, so I just wandered away.
I found out about my hearing loss when I was 17, and I was thinking like he had to have the diagnosis wrong because I hadn't done anything to affect my hearing as I was growing up. He kept asking me, did you listen to loud music? Had you ever had damage to your ears? And I kept saying, no, no, no.
The number one disability that the Veterans Administration is seeing right now is noise-induced hearing loss and tinnitus.
I can't really hear anything, and it just kind of makes me feel unsafe when I can't hear what's going on at night.
When the hearing loss was confirmed, I felt that this is a challenge for all of us. He's a child who's faced by something that is different from many kids, and being different is difficult.
Hearing loss, I know, began when I was a young captain in the Army, about maybe 8 years into my career, and I noticed I could hear a watch ticking on one side in one ear, but I couldn't hear it in my other ear.
At four, Mom noticed that I started not responding to her, and they tested me. That is actually the very first time that anybody told my parents, told me, that I had hearing loss.
It's funny, when I hear about hearing preservation or hearing conservation now, that means so much more to me than it did when I was a child, or even when I was a soldier and we were told to wear hearing protection.
Unlike many cells in the body that can be replaced after they've been damaged or killed, the hair cells of the inner ear don't grow back. At least they don't grow back in mammals.
As a board member and someone with hearing loss, my hope is that the Hearing Restoration Project is successful. Some great science has taken place over the course of the past 7 years since the project was kicked off.
Hearing loss is incredibly common. It's one of the most common sensory deficit among humans.
The long-term goal of the Hearing Restoration Project is to come up with therapies that will allow cells in the inner ear to regenerate and replace lost hair cells. This would greatly improve the quality of life of people who are suffering from hearing loss.
In 2012, I got diagnosed with Usher syndrome. It is the leading cause of deaf blindness. Hearing health is such an underrated aspect of our lives that we just take for granted.
I remember the frustration just as a mother, just like, am I really understanding my kids?
It took me longer to talk than most kids because I couldn't hear what they were saying, so I couldn't like copy it.
The Hearing Restoration Project scientists work on different animals, some of which can regenerate and some cannot.
Top-notch scientists not only review the grants, but there's a whole board of trustees that look at the different grants and figure out which are the areas most important for funding.
There must be some biological mechanism that we can tap into to try and get this to happen in mammals.
If we can succeed in achieving that goal of hair cell restoration, regrowth, and make those hair cells connect up with the auditory nerve fibers that connect to the brain, that would be a marvelous thing for hearing loss, and it would, in all likelihood, correct tinnitus as well for those who have both hearing loss and tinnitus.
I'm glad that the doctors are like working on trying to find out how fish and birds can restore their hearing and people can't. And if they find anything, then people can restore their hearing.
Academics tend to be very vertically siloed in their fields. If you could get them to integrate and find a solution, maybe you could speed things along.
Part of the motivation for setting up the Hearing Restoration Project was to bring together scientists working on this problem from different backgrounds and using different approaches. They can achieve more by working together and collaborating than they could do by working independently.
Our next goal is not only for him to succeed in life, but hopefully to have a cure. I'm hoping in my lifetime, but if not, in his lifetime.
The Hearing Health Foundation is working on a cure, and that's very important to me because I just feel like I'll be able to be more independent.
I hope for one day HHF to not have to exist anymore. If it ceases to exist, then it accomplished what it needed to accomplish.
That will be the day that I'm most proud of HHF, when we could put ourselves out of business, when we've cured hearing loss, when we've cured tinnitus, and we've cured deafness.